Get ready to match the stars. Dick Martin. Brett Summers. Charles Nelson Reilly. Connie Van Dyke. Richard Dawson. And Fanny Fly. As we play the star-studded big money match game 77. And now, here's the star of match game 77, Gene Rayner.
When they see one.
Thank you for being so perceptive and such a superb judge of talent. Thank you so much.
I think I'm going to be sick.
You can wait a half hour until we're finished. Oh, In the meantime, would you a brisk round of applause for Carmen Martinez and
Certainly.
Everett Powell.
We get to hear Everett talk.
Carmen, now that you're a rich lady, how do you feel?
Well, I feel like I was born here, and I think I'll just stay in California and not go back to New Mexico.
She got $3,800, and that's made her very happy. And now she's being challenged by Everett Tao, who did quite well with his first round question, matched two of our celebrities. Right, Everett?
Yeah.
You're from North Carolina, right?
Yeah, a little old place called Candler.
Called what?
Candler.
Candler.
Yeah.
Would you spell that, please?
Well, it's C-A-N-D-L-E-R.
Oh, Candler.
Oh, yeah.
Candler. Candler. How many people there?
Well, if ain't nobody got killed in the last few years, there's just still very few there.
You know, I'm standing here talking to this guy, and I don't understand a word he said so far. Not one word. You don't know what you're saying either. All right, we're even. We'll continue with this game right after we do a little business with you. Okay. Now we're ready. Push the button. Reveal the other question in this first round. Carmen, you want A or B?
I'll take B.
B, okay. You got it. You're a pretty square bunch, aren't you?
I saw it right off.
Thank you, right over there. Norman's restaurant has strange vegetables. Instead of artichoke hearts, they serve artichoke blanks. It's a good one.
Oh, I like that. Thank you.
All right.
Just don't catch it.
See, that wasn't too hard, now was it? Carmen? Norman's restaurant has strange vegetables. Instead of artichoke hearts, they serve artichoke blanks.
Kidneys.
Kidneys, okay. That was one of the possibilities, kidneys.
Kidneys are very good artichoke kidneys, but artichoke livers are much better.
Artichoke livers are better than artichoke much kidneys, I say. How do you fix them?
Oh, always with grease, lots of grease.
Lots of grease, yeah.
Everett would know about that.
What do you say?
Hi, Han.
Hello there.
I think that question passed me right by. I think I missed it. I don't think I understood it. I said artichoke thorns. You know if artichokes have those little thorns
they
in
do
them?
They do indeed, yes.
True.
You must cut them off before you boil them.
Yeah.
Right.
No, you cut them off after you boil them.
No,
you
take
them
a scissors.
Out.
I cut mine off
before
you boil them, yes. They must be boiled exactly 40 minutes. Hello, Charles.
I've been eating too many artichokes.
Enough of that. Ready? Go.
The news tonight in New York. No, the artichoke hearts was a very emotional thing for me when you read the question because that's the name of my boat, artichoke hearts.
No.
Yes.
Really?
It's livers, I said.
Artichoke livers. Well, getting livers and kidneys here, Carmen, but we are not getting any kidneys, and she's looking for kidneys.
I'm sorry. I'm really glad that Brett is on the show.
Why?
Because her answer was dumber than mine, and I wrote feet.
Artichoke feet.
I don't know about that.
Strange strange vegetables in Norman's restaurant. Instead of artichoke hearts, they serve artichoke kidneys.
I was there, a guy said, 2 pound of kidneys, please.
2 pounds?
He said, kidneys. He said, I said kidneys, didn't I? Kidney.
There it is.
Thanks for coming.
Okay. Show us your kidneys.
They're glued on. I said livers.
Livers.
Sorry.
Okay, so there we are at the end of round one. Scores 2-1 in favor of the challenger. Now we go to round two and ask the challenger whether he wants A or B.
Well, let me see here now.
Think it over now.
That's a biggie right here.
That's a big decision there.
I'm going to take a change and take A again.
You're going to take A again?
I'm going to give it a shot.
Give it a shot.
Right.
All right, you had A last time.
Do I beg your pardon?
You're the one who can't be understood. I can be understood. You can't say I beg your pardon to me.
Well, I know.
I said you had A last time.
I know it, but I've got two L O T.
Yes, that's right. What'd he say?
Whatever he wants. He said he got two.
She knows.
He said he got two out of them.
All right. That's right. When Weird Willie went into the restaurant, the maitre d' was shocked because Willie gave him $5 and asked to be seated in the blank. You don't play. You don't play.
Oh, I don't play. I'm excellent.
You and Brett. Weird Willie went into the restaurant. The maitre d' was shocked because Willie gave him $5 and asked to be seated in the blank.
Weird Willie.
Weird Willie.
Weird.
You do understand it's...
Oh, he weird.
You what? You're meditating.
He said, I'm listening.
Right. He said, I'm meditating. Can't you understand?
He said, meditating.
Boy, I tell you...
Well, his microphone was not on. It was hard to hear over there. Okay, Charles is about finished. I'll give it to you one more time. When Weird Willie went into the restaurant, the maitre d' was shocked. You know what the maitre d' is?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. The maitre d' was shocked because... What is the maitre d'?
Well, that's an old... let me say that word again there. That's the guy that comes and asks you. On his seat, you.
Right, okay. The maitre d' was shocked because...
I don't go in them kind of places anyway. So.
You don't go there, yeah. Right. The maitre d' was shocked because Willie gave him $5 and asked to be seated in the blank.
I'd have to say bathroom.
You say the bathroom.
Oh,
what'd you say?
Everett's a good old boy.
He is.
I said men's room.
There it is. There's one for Everett. You gonna help out that good old boy?
I love Asheville, North Carolina, and they know me there very well. I'd be a fool if I didn't help a custodian of my own faith and everything else. I said men's room.
There we go. Maitre d' was shocked because Willie gave him $5 and asked to be seated in the...
John.
Well, so far he has 5. Now, Everett, the bad news.
I'm sitting here pondering, thinking something is the matter with my education. I didn't know you could be seated in the men's room. I said kitchen.
Well. We are not going to have a discussion or colloquy about whether you or not you can be seated in the men's room, but take my word for it, you can be. Where are we here? We're in the middle of round two. Score is 5-1. You got to go to work when we get back from this commercial. Score 4-5 to win. Here we go.